Well, reality for a physicist is not the same as reality for an economist, or reality for a painter, or reality for a musician, or reality for a lover, or reality for a child. They're very different realities. There's something common to them all, and there's something they may agree on is common to them all. But, I mean, for example, a child will pick up a ball and throw it and pick it up and throw it. And I think I, as a physicist, can watch this and observe with the child that that ball is real because of our common objective view that it's real. Real for the kid that picked it up and real for me who observes the kid picking it up. And I can even pick it up myself and play with it. So anything that has an objectiveness to it, I would define as reality. Now, there's always going to be the problem of, well, who's observing that? Maybe that's just an illusion that you have of even the kid being there in the first place. You can always get into that. But as far as I'm concerned, that leads into endless chains of fuzzy thinking, which may be useful, but at the same time, I don't think it goes very far. It's funny, it's endless, but it doesn't go very far.